Good morning, students. Let's move on to the next type of transfer of heat, that is radiation. Before understanding about radiation, let's see actually what is radiation. See, children, you all must have gone out for play during the morning time. When you go out to play in the sun, you must have felt that it's very hot. After playing for some time, it's very, very hot. And after some time, if you take an umbrella and stand in the sun, what will you feel? You will feel that it is much less hotter as compared. So what happens is here is that the umbrella cuts the heat radiation from the sun. The heat that is traveling from the sun to us is traveling through radiation. And the umbrella is cutting a little bit of radiation. That is why you don't feel much hot. So what is radiation? Radiation is the transfer of heat energy from a hot body to a cold body without needing any medium to travel. Till now you studied about conduction and convection. For conduction, you need solids. You need metals or any kind of solid for heat to transfer. Convection, how does convection take place? Convection takes place through liquids and in air. That means you need a medium, but in radiation, you do not need any medium. The heat is traveling from the hotter body to the colder body without any medium. So this is called as radiation. And radiation is the fastest mode of heat transfer. Now we'll see how does radiation occur. The transfer of heat by radiation, it does not require any medium. Just now I told you, like water, air or any other. Then the transfer of heat occurs by the photons, that is the from the sun. When the radiations come, it is occurred by photons, which are a packet of electromagnetic waves. It is in the form of waves, and it is through it that the heat is carried. Okay, the energy which is carried through waves is called as the radiant energy, and all hot objects emit radiant energy. So whenever energy falls on any other body, it is partly reflected and partly absorbed. To prove, and we will see that at a given temperature, a body radiates most heat energy when its surface is dull black, and least when its surface is highly polished. You can do an experiment here. You can take two cans. One can you have covered with a black paper, and the another one you have covered with a white paper. And then what you have done, you have poured equal amount of water and you have left it in the sunlight for almost an hour. And you will temperature, you can use a thermometer to measure the temperature. So which can will you find more hotter, children? You will find that the black can will be more hot as compared to the white can. So what does this prove? This proves that darker bodies absorb more heat, and also it emits heat radiation better, whereas lighter bodies do not absorb much heat. That is why you must have seen that during summers, we prefer to wear light colored clothes as compared to the darker colors of clothes. Okay. Yesterday we studied about the application of conduction. Today we will study about the application of convection and the application of radiation. On the coastal areas in the summer time, you have seen that the breeze blows from the sea during the day, and while the night, the direction of wind is reversed. Now, what is the reason? How it is? See, during the day, you all know that the land gets heated up by the sun. Okay? The land will get heated up by the sun. It will get heated up as compared to the water. So what happens is air over the land. Yesterday in the video I explained, whenever air or water gets heated up, what will happen? It will first of all it will expand. It will expand, and once it expands, it will start rising up. So the air above the land gets heated up, it expands and it starts rising up. Now when this air is rising up, the cold air from the sea will take its place. Okay? So since the air is blowing from the sea towards the land, this is called as sea breeze. Okay? From the sea towards the land. So it is called as sea breeze. Now at night, the procedure is exactly the reverse. What happens is at night, the land, see the children, the land gets heated up also very fast and it cools down also very fast as compared to water. So at night the land is cooled, it has rapidly cooled, but the water at the sea is warmer. So what will happen when the water at the sea is warmer? The same procedure will take place. The air above the sea will get heated up. When it gets heated up, what will happen? The air will expand and it will start rising up. And when the air from the sea starts rising up, the air from the land will blow towards the sea. So since the air is blowing from the land to the sea, this is called as land breeze. Okay? From the land to the sea, to land breeze, from the sea to the land, so sea breeze. I hope, children, that it's clear to all of you. Then the car engines are cooled by convection current set in water pipes. You all must have seen that in the car engines there are water pipes also. Okay? And the water pipes, through the water pipes the car engines gets cooled up. Then smoke and hot gases produced in the factories. You must have seen factories have got very tall chimneys. What is the reason? Why? Because you all know that the smoke will rise up. Okay? When it gets heated up, the smoke will rise up, it will move up and it will escape through the chimneys. So these are the application of convection current. Okay? So children, always remember that wherever there is air is heated up, it will always rise up. It will always move up. So hot air will always rise up and cold air will always move down, because cold air is more dense. Okay? And hot air is lighter. So hot air always moves up and cold air, since it is more dense, it will come down. Then we'll see some application of radiation. Where is it used? Cooling devices of car radiators. Car radiators are painted black. And why it is? So that the cooling effect by radiating heat. When the radiation takes place, it will remain hot. So that is why it is painted black. Room heaters have polished and shining surface. Why? Why do room heaters have polished and shining surface? Just now I told you that when the room heaters have polished and shining surfaces, it will radiate more heat. Okay, light colors or shining surfaces radiate more heat. Brightly polished objects, they will retain internal heat for a long time. Just now I told you we feel comfortable when we wear light colored clothes in summer, because light colored clothes absorb less amount of radiant heat, and in winters we prefer to wear dark clothes. Then buildings which are whitewashed or painted in light colors stay cool in summer. You all know that during summers we like to paint the buildings also. The buildings which are lighter in color, they will remain cool. Why? Because it will not absorb heat. Okay? It will radiate all the heat. So for today, children, we will wind up. The rest we will continue in the next class. Thank you and be safe.